have to do the hard work of organizing. Going door to door, neighbor to neighbor, getting people registered to vote. Making sure that they're mobilized. Making sure they're excited. Making sure we're getting our candidates' messages out. I'm going to dig a little bit into this because I want you to understand what 23 and 24 looks like. There are no off years for the Democratic Party. Now here in Arizona, I would say we need to make sure that we have two Democrats actually serving in the U.S. Senate. And it, excuse my language, it pisses me off. When we get people elected to office, and we work hard to get them to elected positions at every level, and they turn their back on the people who brought them to the dance. Not just turn their back on our party, but turn their back on this state and this country. Now, I've known Ruben for a while. He's never gonna turn his back on the folks in this room. He's never gonna turn his back on Arizonans. Those are the type of people we need in office. And I don't want to, as a vice chair of the DNC, ever have to wonder whether Democrats are gonna take the right vote in the U.S. Senate. I was just talking to Ruben about this. Because you know what? The DCCC last cycle messed up. Yep. Both here in Arizona 6, where we're going to elect a Chris Pinello, and in Arizona 1, where we're going to elect my friend Jerry Hodge. We will pick up both of those seats again. And Ruben and I are going to make sure that the DCCC and other committees in Washington invest the resources on the ground in these districts so that we can all move on the finish line. I was talking about this earlier. I talked to Katie Hobbs the other night up in Phoenix. One seat in both chambers. One seat in both chambers. And that can happen right here in Legislative District 17 with all of your help. Once we get those seats, we're gonna get Katie Hobbs the majority she needs to start pushing a progressive agenda forward for all Arizonans. Now, I'm a yellow dog Democrat. You remember Ann Richards? Ann Richards, the governor of Texas, famously said in her last debate, yes, in her debate against George Bush, she goes, George, you know, if there was a yellow dog on the ballot with a D next to its name, I would vote for that yellow dog before I vote for you any day of the week. I'm that type of Democrat. Because I know if there's any Democrat, it's going to be better than a Republican. But when we have a Republican acting like a Democrat, we gotta make sure we take that candidate out. And we're gonna do that this time. But let me just say, I started in politics with a bushy-haired college professor named Paul Wellstone. And some of you might have remembered Paul. Paul used to famously say that he represented the Democratic wing of the Democratic Party. I do too, because I'm a progressive Democrat. Right? We have conservative Democrats, we have centrist Democrats, we have progressive Democrats, and we have leftist Democrats. And guess what? They're all welcome in this big tent party of ours. They're all welcome. Now, we have the tendency here to be the Eeyore party, the Democratic party, right? The woe is me, half glass empty party, right? This Democrat's too young, that Democrat's too old, this Democrat's too left, that Democrat's too conservative, right? Oh, you know what I'm talking about. We need to stop agonizing Democrats and start evangelizing. Stop agonizing, start evangelizing. We have an amazing story to tell as Democrats. When it came time to defend abortion rights in this country, Democrats delivered. When it came time to defend our democratic institutions, voting rights, and our democracy, Democrats delivered. Let's stop agonizing. Let's start evangelizing. There have been no president and vice president in our nation's history that have done more to deliver for the American people than Joe Biden and Kamala Harris in their first 2 years. We have protected marriage equality, we have historic student debt relief, decriminalized marijuana offenses, capped insulin at $35. My gosh, Democrats, with a story to tell like this, we should be singing it for every corner. We also need to stop agonizing. and start organizing. You know, the most effective and important form of political persuasion is face-to-face. Neighbor to neighbor. Person to person. Talking, but more listening to people's hopes and dreams and their aspirations. When we connect with voters on that level, we will win. But that means not just knocking next October, start knocking now. Start building a relationship with voters around the issue, around the concerns that they care about and about their dreams for their community. When we do that, we will win. So let's stop agonizing and start organizing, truly organizing. And when it comes to BIPOC communities, I can tell you wherever I go in this country, they are sick and tired of the Democratic Party just showing up in the last 2 months of an election asking for their vote. Let's start delivering for those communities. Let's start making sure they're hearing from us year-round, every single day. Let's keep fighting for a country that affords an opportunity to every person who works hard and believes in the beauty of their dreams. Let's keep fighting for a democracy that ensures more voices are participating and that all voices are represented. Let's keep fighting for a woman's right to choose, for our environment and planet, for immigration reform, for sensible gun reform, for public schools, for the right to organize and bargain collectively, for criminal justice reform, for fair taxation, for black and brown communities, for the LGBTQ community, for trans youth, for peace, and lastly, Democrats. Pima County Democrats, let's fight for a world that recognizes, despite our differences, we are still all united by a common thread of humanity. Thank you so much, Pima County.